He has no intention, from everything he said, of leaving Chicago. He lives here, he works here. It was just announced that he's engaged to one of his Virginia Woolf co-stars, Carrie Coon.
Carrie Coon.
I think he likes living and working.
Well, he's
in
probably
Chicago.
The most powerful man in show business in Chicago right now. Who is bigger than him? Who lives in Chicago currently? When you look at the movie thing, you look at the who has got the clout he's got anymore.
I agree.
Would you think of anybody who's bigger than him?
I mean, Bob Falls is in a different way. I mean, he produces stuff and directs things, obviously, biggest theater company in Chicago.
Right. But still, Tracy's got this kind of unique, he's in this unique place at the moment to really kind of, you know, do good for his town, it seems.
If you were going to look at Steppenwolf, would you have said that the person who's going to loom largest of all of them would have been Tracy Letts?
If I hadn't looked at Tracy Letts when I was watching him, then as you were, Nina, like 10, 15 years ago, I'd never have anticipated he would be where he is now. I don't think he would have done it. So you've been talking about the second coming of Tracy Letts. His career's been in waves.
Yeah. Well, I mean, so early on, by the way, he did move to Los Angeles to try to really pursue acting wholeheartedly. And one of my favorite sort of small roles he got was on the Seinfeld episode, the Festivus episode. So it comes across every year during the Christmas time. But, you know, it didn't work out. He didn't like it. I think that's why he's committed to staying in Chicago. He wasn't very sort of creatively satisfied or personally satisfied in Los Angeles. It didn't suit him. And, you know, he came back and he started writing plays, which got a lot of attention in Chicago, Killer Joe, Bug, but those plays didn't really sort of get national attention until there were London productions,
right.
about eight or nine years ago.
He's Mr. Mainstream, right? Mr. Hollywood, Mr. Homeland, but he's still, you know, giving props to the storefront. What more
Absolutely. And he's a multiple threat because he can write his own ticket, which is what he's doing. And then he goes and takes, you know, this revival and just gets an Emmy for it.
Right.
Unbelievable.
A Tony for it, even.
Unbelievable.
Also, by the way,
Emmy will be on for Homeland.
Chris, you and I have interviewed him before. He can be a little prickly. He's not always the warmest guy to interview. So it's kind of nice to see him get choked up when he's accepting the award, right?